Hi everyone, this is Arcadius and welcome back to Naval Creed. Today we'll be reviewing the newest British battleship that has been released, HMS Warspite. Now, this ship is the newest free XP ship that you can purchase, and you kind of already know my opinion on free XP ships if you've watched my earlier videos on them. They are nothing exactly special. They're pretty much ships we already have in the game, just changed just a little bit. So for example, actually it might be easy to go this way. We have a Kaishi or Yamato refit. It's pretty much just exactly the same as Yamato. We have Missouri, which is almost exactly like Iowa. We have Ohio or Louisiana, which is slightly different, but it has the same basic capabilities as a Montana. And then there's Tiger, which is pretty similar to a Congo or a Queen Mary, depending on how you look at it. So, yes, they are different ships, however, they don't have different playstyle. And the same follows through with the Warspite. Warspite is, if you don't know the history of the ship, one of the most famous ships, but it's also a member of Queen Elizabeth class. So you can see the similarities to the Queen Elizabeth in the game. So that's right off the bat. Also, this ship was a lot cheaper than I expected it to be. It was only 480,000 free XP. With something like Ohio and Akaishi being 1.5 million or billion, I think it was. I'm not quite sure. Regardless, it was a higher number than what I expected, but Warspite was a lot lower. So if any of you have no problem grinding for XP, then you can certainly earn the ship for not that much work. Alright, so enough about that. Let's get on to the ship herself. She's quite thick, as you can tell. She is very wide, so that does make her kind of an easy target, but let's see what other stats we have. So she has 58,900 health points, 30% torpedo resistance, so that's pretty good. 330mm of armor. What is that? That's about 13 inches. That doesn't actually sound correct, but it does say that the belt armor is 13, so maybe that is. Her armor is not terrible in the few games I've played with her. I've only played her once or twice so far, so I haven't had all the experience, I guess you could say, with dealing with the ship, but she does seem pretty strong in the armor department, whereas Queen Elizabeth can be quite easily citadeled if you hit the right spot. I don't think I've been able to citadel Warspite easily yet. So she may have a slightly upgraded armor scheme in regards to that. Alright, next we have the guns themselves. 381 or 15-inch guns. 2 rounds a minute, 45-second, 180-degree turn time. The shell velocities are pretty good, and so is the fire chance. If you read up on the stats of the ship on the Naval Creed Warship page, these are, I'm pretty sure, the same guns that you find on Vanguard. So those are actually pretty powerful themselves as well. Let's take a look at them here. Yes, the fire chance isn't as good, nor is the rate of fire, but they do have the same shell velocity at least. And it looks like the damages might be the same too. Yep, the damages are the same. Alright, so she has the same, basically, guns as Warspite. Now, these guns shoot out to a whopping 20.7 kilometers. That's like Tier 8 battleship matchmaking range, and it's impressive, if nothing else. Also, her secondary range is 6 kilometers base. That's the farthest at this tier. I'm pretty sure I put a secondary... Yep, I put a secondary skill on her for giggles. I could go full secondary build, but I just... Well, actually... No, I can't. It doesn't look like I have that ability. Well, regardless, secondaries, I mean, you have the 6-inch here, and then you have a couple 4-inch on top, so they're not that powerful, but you do get a few thousand damage with them. And honestly, it's funny just to watch the secondary start shooting at over 7 kilometers at matchmaking tier 6.5. Alright, so what else do we have? We have speed of 24.8 knots, so she loses 0.2 knots when compared to Queen Elizabeth, but nothing major. She also has a fighter. Let's see, she has 3 fighters. Now, They may change the modeling of this in the future, because right now the aircraft is facing towards the front of the ship, yet it's supposed to take off towards the side. And if I get a chance to in-game, I'll launch the aircraft, and you'll actually see that the entire aircraft does like an entire 360, plus a little bit more, and then launches off the fighter, or off the deck. So it's kind of funny to watch. Maybe they'll fix that in the next patch, we'll see. Alright, so another thing is that she has just a heal and a repair, nothing special, but she has a certain specific module that you can equip. Now it's called Old Warrior, and I thought it was actually going to be an increase, but it's literally only a decrease in ability. You lose 25% of your rotation speed for your main battery, and you get more accuracy, I guess you could say, 18% more accuracy. But honestly, the downside that it doesn't tell you, or at least when I used it, is that your secondaries don't fire. When I had the Old Warrior module equipped, my secondaries were not firing at all, even though I was within 2 kilometers of ships. So I don't know if that's supposed to be purposeful or not, but I just switched to reload and rotation, and my secondaries work fine. And I like the ship the way it is now. Also have steering gears, and Queen Elizabeth's, and actually the entire British battleship and battlecruiser line have problems with detonation. So I have magazine defense as well to help eliminate that problem. So now that we went over the ship, let's toss her into the game and see what we can do. Alright, here we have ourselves a game. We have one carrier, a bunch of battleships, a couple cruisers, and one destroyer. So actually this might be one of the better games that I've had in this ship. Right off the bat, I'm going to tell you I have health buffs and speed buffs applied, as always. So both of those stats will be higher than what you would normally see. So gun reload of 23 seconds, that's with all the buffs applied. Without it, I think it's like 26 seconds or so. So it can actually be pretty rough. Actually, at 2 rounds a minute, it'll be 30 seconds base reload. So I've shaved off 7 seconds, which can be quite a difference when you're in the middle of a battle. Alright, so I'm actually going to launch the fighter plane now, so you can watch this. Watch this. Spins all the way around and then launches. I think it's hilarious. Alright, so let's see what we can do. So even with the gun rotation, your guns still turn pretty slow. It's one of those where you pick a side to shoot from, and you stay on that side the entire game, and you stay on the sides. Honestly, though, there's nothing wrong with this ship. I haven't been able to find a definitive flaw, I guess you could say. She's just a pretty basic British battleship. It's literally like Queen Elizabeth, but a little bit better, which is exactly what she is, but that's how she feels as well. So I guess if that was the point that they were looking for when they designed her, then they nailed that right on the head. So gun angles, we were just about to see them, are that kind of angle. It's not the best, but as a battleship, you do have the armor to at least take some shells. So here's another Queen Elizabeth. Let's toss some shells her way. I'm still getting used to the shell velocity and the shell arc. So that was actually pretty good for a third game. I think I've only had 2 games so far in the ship. That might not have been enough lead, but that's fine. Queen Elizabeth is definitely easier to hit than a Dunkirk right now. And we got some pretty solid damage too, 8,700. Alright. So the main thing that this ship is going to want to shoot at is battleships and cruisers. You're going to want to stay away from destroyers as much as you can. And carriers, well, you don't really have the armament or anti-aircraft armament to defend yourself. We didn't actually go over AA, so we'll have to take a look at that after the game. But it's not anything spectacular by any means. So you want to do your best to stay away from the attention of the carriers as well. So mainly battleships, because at this tier, 15-inch guns can actually overpen most bow armor on battleships. So even if they bow in, you can go right through their nose and get some major damage. In that case, I was a broadside, but that was still almost 14,000 damage. That was pretty good. Alright, so the secondaries are opening up at 7 kilometers, which at this tier is just hilarious to me. The only other ship that has really long-range secondaries is Dunkirk, and those only go out to 5.5 kilometers base. You probably add a few buffs to them, and you may be able to add the secondary module, so they may actually go to about 7 kilometers as well, but secondaries on Dunkirk are for pure defense only, I guess you could say, and they're only situated in the stern, so they're not very good either. But let's focus secondaries on the Arethusa and start getting some chunk damage on this Warspite itself. So this is a good way to show you the armor. I was actually able to citadel the Arethusa with a secondary. That's hilarious because it's only shooting high explosive. No armor piercing. Alright. So this is the broadsiding Warspite, where if it was a Queen Elizabeth, you would expect some citadels. You do not get citadels. So that works out. You do only have 3 heals, so keep that in mind. And you have enough superstructure on Warspite that doesn't matter what ship you go against, you're going to have enough free real estate on top of your ship that any kind of secondary is going to do you damage. I want to focus on this Queen E with my secondaries right now. And see if I can get this Dunkirk down with green guns. I'm going to pop a heal because I'm just melting away. But we're getting some good damage on enemy ships. We're getting close to the Byron though. That could pose a problem. I just realized we out-secondary a Byron. That's funny. Alright, cool. So let's see what we can do to the Byron, because Byron doesn't have as much health as me. And we did more than half damage to this ship. That's amazing. Okay, so we're going to just let the secondaries shoot whatever they want. Actually, no, we're going to focus on the Queen Elizabeth again. We lost a secondary. That's not good. That's fine. Your secondaries, as fun as they may be, they're not going to win you the game by any means. So they're nothing like Illinois, where you can use them effectively. They're just like basic secondaries where they're there, but against big targets like battleships, they're just there to tickle the enemy ship. And the 15-inch guns are where the main damage comes from, and honestly, they do their job pretty well. I don't really use high explosive at this tier, even though it is one of only a few British battleships that can actually use high explosive still. We're being dropped by the carrier now. Mainly because with 15-inch guns, armor piercing goes through the nose, so you don't really have to worry about anything else like that. Okay, so our repair is down, unfortunately, because I repaired the double fire earlier. So now we have a somewhat permanent flooding, which could cause problematic if the carrier decides to keep attacking me, which it is. I'm going to put up my fighter, but that means I have to finish off this Dunkirk, because the Dunkirk is just going to shoot it down as soon as it goes up. Okay, so between the repair, or the heal I should say, I actually didn't lose much damage, or health. There we go. We almost kept the base, but that's fine. I'm actually confused on where this carrier... Oh yeah, I was going to say, it's like right there. Alright, so she's going to go on the right side of the island, I'm going to have to be forced to go on the left side because I don't have the speed to actually catch her, so I have to try and cut her off instead. But we have 6 aircraft shot down, which is relatively good for a low-tier battleship. But they're just going to keep coming. I think Rojo has, what is it, 32? No, maybe 40. I don't know. I'm not that big of a carrier person, so I don't know all the stats off the top of my head. But I know it doesn't have any more than 40 or so. Now I'm contemplating switching to high explosive here. But I know that if I get the Citadel on this ship, which is quite easy to do, I can do some massive damage. Also, that fighter is going to town. I'm shooting down so many aircraft. It's actually a pretty powerful fighter. Alright, so we did get 2 Citadels, and that torpedo strike should actually finish her off here. There we go. Alright, so we have ourselves a game. So let's see how we did. 237,000 damage, 88 shell hits, 12 aircraft shot down, which is pretty respectable for a low-tier battleship, especially being a British one, too. 3 Citadels, 3 fires, 87 secondary hits, 6,800 base XP. She is not a free XP ship, so you cannot use her to grind free XP very effectively. But we had 202,000 damage in armor piercing, we had 21,000 damage in the 3 fires we set with our secondaries, and then secondaries themselves did 14,000 damage. So not a lot by any means, but still more than what you would usually expect for secondaries at this tier. So they're fun just to play around with, but not enough to actually make them be useful. And so you have these 4 secondaries here, and then these mainly just point towards the bow, I believe. And these are the ones that are actually able to aim towards the stern, because you don't actually have many secondaries in the back at all, if any. Final verdict on the ship. If she were more expensive, I would say just ignore her for right now until you have enough saved up to purchase her. But since, to me, I think she's relatively evenly priced at 480,000 free XP. I'm pretty sure that's what it was, wasn't it? Actually, if it was jump ships, let's go all the way across. Yeah, 480,000. With that price, it's not impossible to get that far in a relatively short time. Especially if you already have other Prism ships you can use to grind. So if you have the free XP, go for her, definitely. But if you are still working on grinding branches or whatever like that, she's not going anywhere, and she's not going to help you grind any branches. She's just going to be nice and pretty in your port, but won't be able to give you any more added benefits than anything like a Queen Elizabeth or a Nelson. So it's really up to you on whether you want to get her or not. She's free, so you have no limit to when to purchase her. All you have to do is grind your XP. But if you already know how to do that effectively and you have a good ship to do it, then she can be yours in, let's say, a week if you don't have premium time. So it's really up to you. She's a good ship, no major drawbacks, no major points that would make her any better than any other ship though either. So with that, I will wrap up today's video. If you liked the video, make sure you like and subscribe, and join me tomorrow while we start our British cruiser line with Black Swan. So again, thank you for watching, and take care.